Bonjour et bienvenue chez Vacances.net, c'est Jujubiz. Je me trouve actuellement avec Henry J, un des casters anglophones. Henry,
what do you think about this event so far, especially, you know, being on home soil for you and everything like that?
For me, it's amazing. I haven't actually done many events in London. There's been a couple before, and it's so fun to have a major here as well. The major is what it's all about. It's what we all aspire to be at. It's what the players want to be at. And I think London is considered one of the better cities in the world. It's a lot of fun to be here. It's been an amazing event. I will say the playoffs haven't been as exciting as I hoped. The quarterfinals and semis, a little bit of a letdown, but we have got an amazing grand final coming up, and hopefully that will save the playoffs that we've had so far.
So speaking of the level of CS, were you expecting this level of CS from the teams going into the tournament? You know, seeing the lineups, seeing the experience and stuff like that, especially from Liquid coming 3-0, Complexity 3-1, like the not necessarily upsets, but you know, surprising results.
Definitely surprising results. The disparity as well between the performance in the studio and in the arena was a little bit alarming for me, because Complexity looked like a world-class team in the group stages. It looked like it could beat anyone. Get them in the booths, and that's when you realize, okay, that is the fairy tale finished. It's all over. They've got a lot to learn, right? They haven't been in the booths before. They haven't been in the big stage. It's a difficult environment to play in, and you saw them struggle. But it's good experience. Like Def, for example, gets to play in front of his home crowd. That's an experience he'll never forget. Liquid, I was a little bit disappointed that they didn't perform as well yesterday. I thought they could actually win the entire thing. Didn't want to say that, but I actually thought they had a shout getting to the final, maybe winning. But Astralis has looked too dominant right now. And I will say as well, Na'Vi, I didn't rate them coming to this tournament. I thought they looked lackluster in the last few months. I wasn't that excited for the prospect of them in the grand final, but their form is impeccable right now. Those two players, Electronic and Simple, just look unbelievably good. Really enjoying their play, and they could actually do it. They could win.
Yeah, my pick'ems got destroyed as well, so I feel you. So we spoke with Moses a couple days ago regarding the NA scene and how he thinks things are going, notably Liquid and Complexity in their performance here. And we spoke to him about the NACS meme, and he kind of passed the torch on to the UK. Do you have any rebuttals?
Well, to be fair, UK had double the amount of players as Sweden did. I think that says it all, to be honest. That's amazing. No, but in all seriousness, it's great to see some UK players getting some recognition, and what a time for it to happen as well when the Major's in London. Whether that'll be replicated, I'm not so sure, but it's nice to see that there are players that can compete, and shows you that enough hard work and dedication, you can make it here. A lot of UK players still have the hard done-bys on enough resources or teams, but if you really want to make it, Smooy has done it, Def's done it, it can happen. We were historically a great Counter-Strike nation. Like in Source, for example, we were one of the best in the entire world in terms of UK players. Sadly, a lot of players like myself got old and left the game. Now we need some younger generations to step up and show us what they can do. It's starting to happen now, and I reckon by 2020, we might actually have a decent UK team.
On that note, about development of the UK scene and stuff like that, what does the UK scene need to get to that point, to have that great team by 2020? Do you need a catalyst of some sort, investment? You know, what could the UK scene benefit from?
We definitely need some more opportunity. I think right now, the fact that these younger players are going out to play to countries like America and playing with German teams and stuff, they're getting that experience they need. I don't think they'll be playing in international teams forever, but it's great to see them like learn how to play the game correctly, and hopefully they can come back to the UK and maybe develop something amazing in the future. I don't really have the solution. This is a question I get asked all the time. Like, I wish I knew why it's gone so badly. I feel like we lost some of our key members from the Source days. If you look at the French team, for example, you have Shoxi from Source, you have Existence, Source legend, right? Players that have the experience and can train up these younger players. There's no real old heads in the UK left. None of those guys stayed around, so it's a little bit of a difficult journey for the younger players. There's no one to really guide them. There's no real community in that sense. It's a little bit strange. I don't really have the solution. Hopefully, we'll see maybe a new UK organization maybe step up and start paying some salaries, and maybe some guys get some opportunities. But like I said, 2020, maybe we'll start getting there.
Bright future ahead, hopefully. We'll see. Yeah. But anyways, thank you so much for your time. Enjoy the final. It's going to be insane, like you say. C'était Jujubiz et Mickey pour Vacarme. Ciao.